our Facebook followers and our YouTube followers, amen, and our viewers. I want to let you know that we appreciate you. We thank God for you. We know that the word of God that you're hearing from us, amen, through us, amen, it's causing you to prosper and be in good health even as your soul prospers, because that's what the word of God is designed to do. So I want you to be encouraged, amen, as we get ready to minister to you the word of God this morning. Be expecting to God to begin to reveal to you that he's prospered you. He's caused you to be in good health and even as your soul prospers, amen?
Amen.
So we're going to believe in God that this word of God will be a nourishment to your spirit, soul, and body. So, all right then. Well, with no other further ado, let's get ready. We're gonna. We really want to encourage you, our Facebook followers and viewers, to really just go when you go on, hit the like button, indicator that you like what we're doing here, the word of God that we're presenting to you, amen, and that it's enriching your life and causing you to grow. This is our whole purpose of being. Before you is to make sure that you get the word of God and your faith grows, because that's what faith is designed to do. It's designed to grow. So as you take hold of this word of God, which develops your faith, you should be growing in your faith. Your faith should be growing and maturing. Amen. And you'll be able to really stand firm and be rooted and grounded in the promise of God. So before we get ready to go, but we want to make sure, before we get ready to go into our teaching, we want to make sure that we encourage you that are listening and following us, that we make sure that you are born again and that you've received Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. And if you haven't done that, we want to take that opportunity to do that, to bring you into a relationship with Jesus Christ, because that's when the word of God can really take root in us, is when we have that relationship with Jesus Christ. So we want to get you to that place this morning before we get ready to get into the word of God. If you have not born again and you accepted Jesus Christ, your personal Lord and Savior, it's not a hard thing to do. It's not any magic or anything like that. All it consists of is you just repenting of your sins and asking God to come into your life through your faith in Jesus Christ and let him live in you and have his way in your life. Amen. And it's not a hard thing to do. Amen. All you have to do is just believe and receive. Amen. And repentance really means, it means change the way you think. So right now, I want you to repeat this prayer after me and repeat it in faith, and God always rewards your faith. Right now, I want you to repeat this after me. God, I'm asking you to forgive me of my sins, my transgressions, and my iniquities. And I'm believing you right now that in the name of Jesus, I have been forgiven of my sins. And I'm cleansed. And I'm born again. And now I put my faith completely in the finished work of Jesus Christ in my life. I'm born again. You're my father. And I'm a family. I'm a member of the family of God. And I thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap. You that received that, made that confession, amen. You did it by faith, amen. You're in the family of God. We want to welcome you to the family of God, amen. You're born again, amen. You're born again by your confession of faith, by you coming to a place where you're willing to change the way you think and start thinking like God. Start thinking like God, amen. Hallelujah. Bless God. All right, let's get ready, amen, to get into the word of God this morning. We're going to talk with you this morning about, we're going to deal with something a little different, but we're getting ready to get into a series of teaching about this, about having a faith conversation. Having a faith conversation. We're going to get into a conversation of faith. And we're going to really encourage you to understand that that's the only conversation. That's the only conversation that you can get involved in, and God is going to get involved in that with you. Amen. All right. Conversation. The word conversation is defined as referring to an informal interchange of thoughts, an interchange of thoughts, information, etc., by spoken words, oral communication between persons. And you're talking. Amen. You can say faith talk. Amen. You're having a faith talk, a faith conversation. Amen. And it's referring to an informal interchange of thoughts. In other words, when you get into this conversation of faith, what you're doing, you're allowing God to interchange his thoughts to you, reveal his thoughts to you. Amen. And I'm going to tell you this here. We need to have faith. We need to have faith in God. Amen. So where is faith? Where is faith place? Where is faith place of origin? Where is faith place of origin? We can go to Romans, the 10th chapter and the 17th verse. And we're going to be reading from the Amplified Version of the Bible. Now, we're talking about faith and we're looking at the origin of faith. Amen. The origin of faith. All right. So faith comes from hearing. What is told and what is heard comes by the preaching of the message concerning Christ. So faith comes by the preaching of the message of Christ. That's how you get faith. Some translations say faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. It's a continual hearing, having a continual conversation with God. Amen. It begins to develop your faith language. Amen. Your ability to hold a meaningful conversation with God. And I want you to understand this here. You can only hold a meaningful conversation with God when you make a decision. You're going to talk to God by faith. You're going to commune with him. You're going to fellowship with him. You're going to allow God to give you his thoughts. And every one of God's thoughts is based upon faith. It's based upon the word of God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless God. When we come to the place where we welcome Jesus Christ into our conversation, faith begins to do its perfect work in us. When we welcome the Lord Jesus Christ into our conversation, and you got to welcome him into it. Amen. You got to let God know. You got to let Jesus Christ know that, Jesus, I want to talk to you. Yes. I want to have a conversation with you. I want to have a dialogue with you. Amen. And I want you to understand this. He's the best person to have a conversation with, because one thing about it, he'll never lie to you. And when you're talking with him, you have to understand this here. He will never bring up your past in the conversation. He's going to always be talking about what God has done for you, how God has delivered you, how he set you free, how God loves you. Amen. And you need to understand that God loves you, that God loves you. Amen. Glory to God. And that, you know, that stimulates the conversation right there. Knowing that you're having a conversation with somebody that's deeply involved in loving you. Yes. He loves you. Amen. You have to understand that. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless God. So when we welcome the Lord Jesus Christ into our conversations, faith begins to do its perfect work in us of transforming us into disciples of Christ. That's what that conversation is all about. When you begin to talk with Jesus Christ, he's going to begin to reveal to you, amen, his deepest desire for you to be his disciple. Amen. To be a follower of him. Amen. And I believe this here. Once you get into a conversation with Jesus Christ, you're going to want to follow him. Yeah. Once you get into a conversation with him, the conversation is going to become so deep, so intimate, so revealing, so transforming that you can't do anything but follow him. Amen. And you'll be willing to do just like the woman at the well. When she got in a conversation with Jesus, he revealed all things to her. He changed her mindset of worship. Yes. He changed her mindset of who she was. And he also set her free from her past. Yes. He delivered her and set her free from her past to such a degree that she was able to go and tell other people about, come see this man called Christ who set me free and told me all truth. He opened up my understanding how to worship God. Yes. Amen. On a level where it pleases God when I worship him. He revealed to me in the conversation that that God is really my father, and he's seeking for such to worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. Glory to God. That's a good conversation. It gets to the level where you get into that conversation where it deals with your spirit and it brings you to the reality of truth. Amen. And that's what truth is. It's the highest level of reality. It's the highest level of reality. Why? Because it's based upon the word of God. Truth is based upon the word of God. Amen. So you're having a conversation with God based upon God's word, and God's word will never fail. It'll never fail you, amen? You that are watching me on YouTube, you that are watching me on Facebook, I want to encourage you to, when you get into a conversation with Jesus Christ, understand that when that conversation is going to impact your life to such a degree that it's going to change your understanding of worship. You're going to worship him in spirit and in truth. It's going to change your understanding of being able to be a witness for him, that you'll be able to go and tell other people to come and see the man that changed your life. That changed everything, every aspect of your life, amen. That set you free from your old habits, amen. Your old way of thinking. What it did, he set you free and delivered you from your old relationships, amen. Because that woman had some wrong relationships, amen. And he told us, I'm gonna set you free from these ungodly relationships, amen. What you think? Well, you think your where you think somebody love you at, I'm going to take you to a place where you realize somebody really can come in contact with the real person, which is God, that really loves you. Yeah. Amen. All right. So now we're going to look at this here about Hebrews, the 11th chapter. And we're going to look at the 11th chapter through the first verse. It says, now faith is the substance. We're talking about having a faith conversation. Having a faith conversation. Having a conversation of faith. Having a conversation where you're talking with God. Amen. Amen. You're talking with God now. I want you to really get this in your spirit that you're talking with God now. Amen. God longs to talk to you and to reveal himself to you as he's your father, that he loves you. Amen. I really want you to get that in your spirit. This is the best conversation you'll ever have. This is this conversation that will impact your life forever. It'll deal with you. It'll deal with your eternal destiny and your right now position. Amen. So faith, we're going to look at faith. It says Hebrews 11 chapter in the first verse. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now faith, and realize this here, faith is always now. Faith is never, you can never have a faith conversation talking about what you're going to do. Well, one day, when I get things right, amen, it goes on a higher level than that. Amen. It goes on a level where you begin to see God do some awesome things in your life and to begin to transform you into the image and likeness of his son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Understand this here, that this is the conversation that's going to transform everything in your life. It's going to change everything. This conversation is the changing point in your life. It's going to change your position. It's going to change your thoughts. And this conversation is going to change the way you see God, the way you see yourself, and the way you see other people. This conversation. This is a very important conversation. Faith conversation. Let's have a faith conversation. Amen. So now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. The substance of faith is our spiritual freedom from doubt. The substance, it's talking about faith is a substance. What it is, it's the faith that substance is that substance is the faith of our spiritual freedom from doubt. Amen. See, this is the substance that you obtain in this conversation. You obtain your spiritual freedom from doubt. Spiritual freedom from doubt. Amen. In this conversation, be prepared to have your spirit free from doubt in this conversation. Amen. When you get in this conversation, it's going to change everything. This conversation with God. Amen. It's designed to change everything. Amen. To change everything. When you get in a conversation with God, understand this here, that you don't have to worry about doubt or fear anymore. You don't have to wonder, doubt is where you're wondering about things. I want you to understand this here. You don't have to wonder, does God love you? Is God concerned about you? You don't have to wonder if God is going to heal you when sickness try to come and attack your body. You don't have to wonder, has God provided for your needs? You don't have to wonder about that anymore, because God, in his word, is going to reveal to you that he's already supplied all of your needs according to his riches and glory that he has in Christ Jesus. Amen. Jesus is going to speak to you in this conversation that don't be weary, don't be faint, don't give up. I have already met all of your needs. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. In this conversation, you're going to get in a conversation with Jesus Christ, and he's going to reveal to you that you don't have to worry about your needs. Yes. He's provided for you. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. In the Amplified Version, I want to break this down to you. I want you to see it in different versions about understanding what faith is, that it's a substance. I want you to really see what the Word of God reveals to us about what faith is. Faith is nothing that you got to hope for. You don't have to hope for it. Faith is an assurance. It's an assurance. It's a substance that sets you free. Amen. Yes. Sets you free. And I don't know about you, but there's a deep desire to want to be set free. Amen. And I know you want to. You want to be set free. You want freedom. Amen. Well, Jesus Christ, when you begin to talk to him, he's going to begin to set you free. He's going to reveal to you that he is the person that God sent to set you free and to give you freedom indeed. Amen. In this conversation. Amen. I want you to understand this here. You have to make this decision that you're not going to talk to nobody but Jesus Christ. And if you're going to talk to other people, they got to be talking about Jesus Christ. Amen. Because he's the one that's going to set you free. Amen. You got to get this in your spirit. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. And understand that God wants you to talk to him. Amen. He's the best person to talk to. Glory to God. He's the only person that you can talk to that's going to build up your confidence. The only person that's going to build up your confidence. And this is what you have to understand. You will not be successful in life if your confidence is not built up. You won't be able to overcome what the enemy is going to present to you. And I want you to understand this. The enemy is going to present to you your past until you can't be delivered from your past. You can't be set free from your past. See, the enemy is going to tell you that you can't be healed because you got to believe the report what the doctor said. The doctor said you got this cancer. You can't be delivered from this cancer. You can't be healed. But that's not what Jesus said. He's not going to talk to you and tell you that you got to settle for this cancer, this terminal illness on your life. You don't have to settle for that. Amen. But he comes because he says, according to your faith, be your healing unto you. According to your faith, be your healing unto you. Amen. You got to believe what he says about you. Amen. He come to give us life and that life more abundant. That's what Jesus came to do. Amen. Glory to God. So look at this in the Amplified Version of the Bible. It says, now faith is the assurance. Faith is an assurance. That substance is an assurance. Amen. It's an assurance. And a title deed. Title deed means the right to. Ownership. You have the right to talk to God. You have the right to get in a faith conversation with God and see God work out all the problems. Revealed to you that it's already been dealt with. Your problem has already been dealt with. Amen. Your problem is trying to make you accept an illusion. Something that's not real. Yeah. Amen. Glory to God. So now faith is assurance, the title deed, the confirmation. You got a confirmation. Amen. When you talk to Jesus Christ, he's confirming to you what God has promised to you. He is the one that's bringing it to pass. You can trust him. That's the confirmation. Amen. And you got to get into the Word of God. I want you to understand this. As you get into the Word of God, it begins to develop your understanding that you're talking to God. You're having a conversation with God. Don't just read the Word of God and read it as some book or some something that some old men wrote because they didn't have anything to do. Every one of those authors of the Word of God, they was inspired by God. God breathed his life into them. He breathed his thoughts into them. He breathed his conviction into them. He breathed his life into them. And they're speaking it to you. When you get into the Word of God, you're having a conversation with the Word of God, and you got to have it by faith. You got to believe that this is God talking to you. He's quickening your spirit, bringing you alive, that he loves you. He has great plans for you. He wants you to understand Jeremiah 29 and 11 is just not some fairy tale. It's a truth revealed to you. When you have a conversation with God, God is telling you this here. This is my plans for you. Yes. These are my plans for you. I plan for you to prosper. Yes. I plan for you to have peace and not evil. Amen. God has, when you get in a conversation with God, God is telling you, you don't have to accept evil. Because I planned peace for you. Amen. I don't know about you, but I would rather have peace than evil. I'd rather have peace over evil any day. Well, God promises you that. But you know what you got to do? You got to take it by faith. You got to take this by faith. Amen. What is faith? Believing God for it. Getting locked in to a conversation with God and let God keep on speaking it to you. Don't come out of that conversation until you got the assurance in your spirit that you can believe God. That you can trust God. Amen. Stay in that conversation. Keep talking to God. Amen. I want you to understand, God is not too busy that he can't talk to you, because God is not busy at all. He's sitting on his throne and he's resting. And what he's trying to tell you to do when you get in this faith conversation with him, get into a place of rest where you trust him, where you're not easily moved. Amen. So he said, now faith is assurance, the title deed, the confirmation of things hoped for. In other words, God wants you to hope. He wants you to have hope in him and him alone. He wants you to have hope in him and him alone. God wants you to have hope in his word and his word alone. He wants you to believe his report. What he's speaking to you, what he's saying to you, believe it. Amen. Believe that God sent his word and his word healed you. Believe that God sent his word and his word healed you. Believe that God sent his word and his word delivered you. It set you free. Believe it. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless God. He says, things hoped for, divinely guaranteed. God guarantees. When you get in a faith conversation with God, when you begin to start talking with God, you can trust God that God guarantees that his word works. And it works every time. It doesn't fail. It doesn't fail. Only reason why it failed, you don't believe. It's according to your faith. It's according to your faith. And I'm going to tell you something. You need to get anchored down, rooted and grounded in believing God's word. Because you're going to need it. You're going to need it. You want to get to the place where the word of God is forever settled in you. Amen. You're going to trust God. Amen. Because there's things coming up on the land. There's things that are here now. In the earth realm that you're going to need God. You're going to need to have faith in God to stand. Jesus made this statement. Said, will there be any faith in the land when the Son of Man come? Will he come to return back? Faith is important. It's your title deed. It's your right to ownership. Because if you don't understand that you have the right to own your good health, the devil will talk you out of it. He'll deceive you and tell you you can't have it. God don't want you broke and poor. Amen. Amen. He wants you to be able to live above and not beneath. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. So it's a divinely guaranteed and the evidence of things not seen. And you have to understand this here. Faith helps you to navigate through things that you don't see to God manifested. It helps you to navigate through things. You need to understand this here. This is your navigational system. Faith is. It helps you to navigate, get you to that point of destination, get you to that place where you're hoping for things. That what you're hoping for, long as what you're hoping for is based upon the word of God, you can trust it, sir, that it's surely going to come to pass. Amen. The thing is, will you endure? Yeah. Will you wait and trust on it? Will you keep on having a conversation with God? And not keep on, and I want you to understand that you're not in a conversation with God if you're going to beg him for something. You can't beg God for anything. You can't approach him because you're his child. Yes. Yes. Children don't have to beg their parents for anything. Amen. Amen. He want to freely give it to you. Amen. Amen. Most of the time, our parents say, most of the time, our parents, they may not have something. They say this here, well, as soon as I get it, I'm going to get it to you. Well, you have to realize this here. God ain't got to soon as he get anything. He's already got it. He already got it for you. He's already given us all things pertaining to life and godliness. He's already given it to you. Amen. But you got to take it by faith. You got to stay locked into your faith conversation with him. Keep talking with God. Keep talking. Stay in a conversation with him. Amen. And avoid all other ungodly conversations. Avoid them. Don't spend time. Don't waste your time in that. Amen. Stay in that faith conversation with God. Amen. Because it'll build up your ability to resist evil communications and evil thoughts, evil imagination. Telling you, you know, make you look at your natural heritage more than you look at your spiritual heritage. Who you are in God. Amen. You must remember that you were made in God created us in the image and likeness of God. You got to remember that. You got to stay focused on that. Amen. Glory to God. Stay focused on that. Amen. And one thing about having a conversation with somebody, you have to be on the same mind level or understanding. Amen. If you're not on the same understanding, the conversation ain't gonna go right. It's gonna have some bumps and ups and downs and everything. And when you're going through ups and downs, you have to realize this here. What you're not doing, you're not understanding God properly. You have to understand him. You have to understand him. Amen. And we're gonna deal with that as we go on in this here. He says, and the evidence of things not seen. And I want you to, on Facebook, I want you to understand this here. If you want to see God, get into the Word of God. If you want to see God, say, I ain't never seen God. Get into the Word of God. He reveals himself in his word. Amen. Amen. You can get a good picture and a good image of God by you getting into the word of God. The reason why people don't understand God is because they spend little or no time in the word of God. When you spend time in the word of God, which is God, you begin to understand you can see God through his word. Amen. Amen. You can see how good God is through his word. God reveals himself through his word. Yes. Amen. Amen. That's the best. That's how you get in a good, solid, committed conversation with God. You got to get into the word of God. Because the word of God, it reveals God's thoughts. It reveals his thoughts. His intents. Amen. His emotions towards you. It reveals that God loves you. We say this scripture, but do we really take it to heart and really get and take that scripture by faith? For God so loved you. I know it say world, but you need to personalize that scripture. John 3:16. For God so loved me that he gave his only begotten son for me. And that if I believe it in him, I will have eternal life. Hallelujah. It's mine to have. Yes. Amen. Amen. See, you got to get an understanding of what this is. You know what it means to have eternal life with God? It means to have an eternal conversation with God all the time. Yes. Being able to talk to God throughout eternity. Being able to fellowship with God throughout eternity. Amen. Well, the start for that, the building stage for that is now. You got to understand this, that your eternity, it starts now. Your eternity starts, and you got to have faith in God now that you can experience it in eternity. Yes. Yes. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless God. Trust God. God loves you. He's not mad at you. God does not have a desire to have you to be his enemy. You have to remember this here. I always stay focused on Genesis 1:26. God said, let us make mankind in our image and in our likeness. God didn't make you in his image and his likeness just for you to be an enemy with him. Right. Amen. 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 He was telling you right there, I want to talk to them. I want to have a conversation with them. Adam had a conversation with God before he fell. And after he fell, he still had a conversation with God. Amen. God is committed in us having a faith conversation with him. Amen. So you want to trust God. You want to believe God. You that are watching on Facebook, I want you to dig down deep and get rooted and grounded and make a commitment that you're going to have a conversation with God. You're going to have, and you're going to have this conversation by getting into the Word of God. You got to get into the Word of God. You got to get anchored, rooted, and grounded in the Word of God. That's where the conversation begins at. Amen. You have to realize this here. People talking about God, I got God in my heart. If you ain't got God's word in your heart, you don't have God in your heart. If you can't quote none of God's word, you can't say none of God's word, you don't have confidence in God's word, you don't have nothing to do with God's word, you don't have God in your heart. Don't fool yourself. You got confusion and misbeliefs and misunderstanding in your heart. Amen. Because only the Word of God has the power to reveal the Word of God. Amen. So I want to encourage you to get into the Word of God as we get ready to end this with you on Facebook and YouTube. You get into the Word of God and you don't let the devil talk you out of it. Amen. The Word of God, the church, you say, the Word of God is my hiding place. Yeah. That was an old song in the church back in the day. They say, the Word of God is my hiding place. Amen. You get into the Word of God, the enemy can't attack you. You get into the Word of God, the enemy can't disturb you. You get into the Word of God, the enemy can't bring no sickness upon you. When you get into the Word of God, you can't do nothing but have God and experience God in every level of your life. So what are you saying, Pastor? I'm telling you, if you want a conversation with God, you want to hear from God, get into the Word of God. Amen. And we'll see you next time. We want to encourage you to come out. I always remember this here. There is a warm seat of welcome here for you at Dominion Life Worship Center. And if I was you, I would let nobody beat me to my warm seat of welcome. We'll see you next time in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand.